Hello friends, welcome to our channel. So in the previous sessions we have seen the programs on strings and also string handling functions. That means we have seen the predefined functions for string operations. So in this session let us have a look on another program, that is copying the content of one string to another string, so without using these string handling function, that means the predefined functions, strcpy. String copy without using strcpy function. So simple. So first of all, we have to take we have to declare two strings and we have to initialize one string, and our problem is we have to copy the content of string 1 to string 2. So for that purpose we have to take individual characters, every character, and we have to copy it to the second string. So for that we will use the iterative statements and the condition where to stop. That means where to stop means here we have to copy every character until we reaches the null character. So we know, as we know that by taking the input, the last character will be the null character that will be appended. So until we reaches the null character, we have to copy every character from first string to the second string. See, for this, so if we use this string copy function, so the logic cannot be written by us. So directly the content of one string will be directly copied to the another string. So here we have to write the logic, that is we have to read each character, we have to take each character and we have to copy it to the second string. So let us see. So first we have to declare two strings. So character str1 of 20 is equal to, let us take direct initialization. So I have taken computer as a direct string to the string 1, and again declare another string but not initialize. So character string and int I. This is for looping. So write the loop, start from 0. And where to stop, the condition, simple, str of 1 of I not equal to slash 0, I plus plus. So starting from 0 and the end condition, that means termination condition, is str 1 of I not equal to slash 0. So where we have to copy, that is to string 2. So str2 of I is equal to str1 of I. A simple assignment. So every character, if I is equal to 0, string of 0 will be copied to string 2 of 0. Close. And after completion of all the characters, copying all the characters from string 1 to string 2, at the end of the character we have to include slash 0, because while printing the string 2, so the compiler will print everything until it reaches slash 0. So we have to add slash 0 at the end of string 2. So that's why after completing, so this loop is for complete copying the content of string 1 to string 2. So here I have to I is equal to slash 0. I have directly initialized it here. So this is a simple program to copy the content of one string to another string. So let us trace here so that you can clearly understand. So here str of 1 of 20 is equal to computer. So this implies str of 0. str1 of 0 is equal to C, str1 of 1 is equal to O, str1 of 2 is equal to M, str1 of 3 is equal to P, str1 of 4 is equal to O, sorry, U, str1 of 5 is equal to T, str1 of 6 is equal to E, str1 of 7 is equal to R, and automatically the last one is 8 is equal to slash 0. So next, here str of 2, for I is equal to 0, see I is equal to 0, str1 of 0 not equal to slash 0, condition true. So str2 of 0 is equal to str1 of 0, str1 of 0. So the value is C. So C is copied to, so as it is a character, we have to use a single quotations. C is copied to str2 of 0. Now I is equal to 1. So same, str1 of 1 not equal to slash 0. So 1 not equal to slash 0, right? Then str2 of 1 is equal to str1 of 1, that is O. Next, I is equal to 2. So here also same, str1 of 2 not equal to slash 0. This is a condition true. So str2 of 2 is equal to str1 of 2. So that is M. And then I is equal to 3. Str, so as we know that I is equal to 3, str1 of 3. Str1 of 3 is P, not equal to slash 0. So condition true. Here also str2 of 3 is equal to str1 of 3. So that is P. Next, I is equal to 4. Again, str1 of 4. This is also not equal to slash 0. So again, condition true. Str2 of 4 is equal to str1 of 4. So this is 4. Is equal to U. Next, I is equal to 5. So here also the condition, str1 of 5 not equal to, so str1 of 5 not equal to slash 0, str1 of 5 is T. So the condition is true. Str2 of 5 is equal to str1 of 5. That means we are assigning str1 of 5 value to the str2 of 5. So here the value is T. Next, I is equal to 6. Here also str1 of 6 not equal to slash 0, str of 1, 6 not equal to slash, not equal to slash 0, that is right. So str of 2 of 6 is equal to str2 of 6, so 1 of 6. So that means E will be copied. Next, for I is equal to 7, again the condition, str1 of 7 not equal to slash 0, str1 of 7 is having R, that is not equal to 0, the condition is true. So str of 2 of 7 is equal to str1 of 7, so the value is R. Next, I is equal to 8, then str, so here I is equal to 8, str1 of 8 not equal to 0, so str1 of 8 not equal to slash 0, so but str of 8 is 0, so condition fails. So automatically the loop, so here the condition fails, so automatically when I is equal to 8, the loop will be terminated. Now the str2 of I is equal to slash 0, at the end of the string 2 we have to include this null character. Now I is equal to 8, so str2 of 8 is equal to slash 0. So this will be, the null character will be assigned to str2 of 8. So now here we have to print f, percentage s str 2. So if you print this string to function, so the compiler will print all the characters until it reaches null character. So it will print C, O, M, P, U, T, E, and R. Here, null character. So it will print the complete word of string 2. So this is a simple program for copying the content of one string to another string without using the string copy function. So hope you understood, this is a simple program, simple logic. So just a single assignment. So we are assigning the each character to the second string, each character of first string to the second string. So where, up to where we have to continue this loop? So we have to continue until we reaches the slash 0, that means null character on the first string. So if you are having any doubts regarding this C programming, feel free to post your doubts in the comment section so that I will try to clarify your doubts regularly. And if you like my videos, share my videos with your friends and subscribe to my channel for getting more videos on this C programming. Thanks for the listening. Thank you very much.